Hello everyone, welcome to our channel IAC Steno. We are starting the passage at speed of 100 word per minute. Start. Sir, I would first like to congratulate you on the short presentation that you gave. Some of the pieces were extremely powerful and they go home very hard. It just shows what one can do if one puts one's energies in a particular direction, the right direction. In India today, perhaps in the world today, we are facing a period of change, the like of which has not been seen ever before, partly because of new technologies that are available, but perhaps more than that because of a new thinking that is taking place around the world. We are for the first time coming out of a mindset which really belongs to past centuries, a mindset which looks at human beings or the world divided up into boxes, into groups, like you just said, of Hindus, Muslims, Sikhs, Christians, and perhaps beyond that, into nations, into ethnic groups, into regions. For the first time, we have started looking at the world, looking at humanity as one integrated whole. We have started realizing that survival does not depend on any one group surviving. It depends on the survival of the whole of humanity. India has played a major role in bringing about this change in thinking. This has been part of our traditional thinking for thousands of years. Gandhiji revived it during the freedom struggle, and during these past 52 years of freedom, we have been struggling hard, first under Panditji, then under Indiraji, to bring this new thinking to the world. For the first time during these last few years, we find that global thinking has started to change. At the same time, the old system fights back very hard. There is a tendency on the one hand to look at the world as one. There is an equal attempt to keep the old systems continuing with change only. Projection, presentation, or perception for the benefit of few. We got out of colonialism, but did exploitation end? It did not. The poorer countries, the weaker countries, still have a net outflow of wealth. The next phase seems to be getting into economic group, which in a sense is no different. It just a different form of exploitation. So we have to fight that as well. India has given the lead during the last 4 or 5 decades, and India will have to give the lead in the coming years also. But to give the lead, we need to do certain things at home. We need to be strong and clear in our minds about where we want to go. Our strength traditionally has been that we have always looked beyond the material into certain higher values, deeper values, perhaps spiritual values. We have looked beyond immediate gains. We have always tried to work for certain ideals. Today, this basic Indian thinking is coming under very severe attack, partially from you, because the real attack is from the materialistic attitude that is coming into our society. That is why I am glad to be with you here today to try and turn your attention not just selling but also at building the nation that we want to build, projecting the ideas, the ethos of India across the world. For that, we need to first look within and see what we need to preserve and what the problems are and the difficulties in preserving it. The biggest attack on our traditional thinking, on our culture, on our civilization is from materialism, which is being brought in partly because of growth, development, because people have access to goods and facilities which they did not have access to earlier, because their incomes have grown, because their standards of living have gone up. The way India has grown during these past 8 or 9 years is well behind what we ever have expected. These problems are going to get compounded. I expect our growth rate to increase even more in the coming years. So, these pressures will increase even more. Therefore, we must be very clear in our minds about the sort of nation we want to build. The biggest danger is going down a purely materialistic route, is that we will ultimately surrender the independence that we won with so much struggle. I see that as the biggest danger. We are independent today not because we won a battle against the British and sent them home. We are independent today because we have followed certain policies, because we have followed a certain ideology, because at every step that we have taken, we have kept in mind the point that the independence that we won could also be lost very quickly. When I talk about the independence being lost, it is not just a question of being ruled by another state. That is perhaps not the way it happens now. At the end of the 20th century, it happens in much subtler ways today. Flexibility in decision making is limited. Options are cut and ultimately you go by a feeling of rightness. Stop.